What is up, guys? Today I wanted to talk on my break. Today I decided to take the time out of my day on my break from work to kind of chit chat and like vlog in my car. I picked up a Clif bar and I picked up my coffee because I caught myself. I feel like when you work so much, you start to like go to restaurants or McDonald's, something quick. You start to gain weight every day. When you work in any setting, I feel like especially like the medical field, it does get stressful because you're dealing with patients, you're dealing with people who are in pain, you're dealing with people that need medical attention, clinical, physical, hands-on work, and it can be a little bit stressing and overwhelming, and it overwhelms like your coworkers and yourselves, and it's kind of like wear and tear on your body, especially when you're a assistant, when you're literally doing work for someone else. You're making their job better. As a dental assistant, that's what you're doing. You're making their job easier. Since it's kind of like my first video vlog having to do with work, I kind of just wanted to talk briefly and explain to you guys why I want to continue doing this vlogging. Work can get stressful. It can get really, really stressful. And what you tend to do and what I try to stay away from is to vent and talk about things that go on in the work environment, and it's just not professional. For me, it makes me uncomfortable. Like when I go back to work and I'm just like kind of gossiping and talking or expressing myself on, you know, what upset me in that moment or whatever. Like we all have our lives and we all have stresses and things that go on, but you know, if we're venting to our coworkers, they're going through the same stress and the same issues that you're going through in that setting, in that work setting. So what I try to do is I try to stay away from venting to like coworkers and like, you know, things like that. And I also don't like calling my family on my breaks or like right after work or like before work, because I feel like work is just such a professional time and it's such a like, I zone in when I'm working. Like this is just work and it shouldn't be anything else but work. So I figured like if I do this car vlogging kind of situation, it's kind of like a venting mechanism and outlet for me. I have a coworker. She has an amazing body, but literally every single day we work, we would go pick up like chicken tenders, McDonald's, pizza, this, that, this. And like I noticed I was gaining weight, but my coworker looked exactly the same. So I'm like, yeah, it's time for some serious changes. Last week I did go to the gym with another coworker of mine, excuse me, at my job. We do have a gym. So I worked out like for my break, but this is actually harder than I thought because I really can't stand eating and speaking at the same time. It's just not my thing. What my plans are with like my channel, this playlist that I have going on with like the dentistry playlist, not everything goes as planned. Not everything works accordingly, or according to how you want your schedule agenda to go. So I mean, God willing, my plans work as planned. I want to explore dentistry more and I want to promote dental health. I mean, that's what I'm going to school for, dental hygiene. So I figured digital media is such an important tool. I am a double major in new media and dental hygiene. I figured it's a great way to correlate both majors by putting my content out here on YouTube, but also promoting dental health through a lens. A lot of people don't realize how important their teeth are Until they go to the dentist and they're like, well, you need to extract, you know. So it's like, your teeth are really important. And, you know, not only for people who are having issues with their teeth, but also I want to, you know, just put myself out there for people like me who are on a journey to find their purpose and who have a, you know, love and passion for teeth. So I think this is a great mechanism and a great tool to use for these kind of things that I'm looking to invest my time in. Today, overall, no matter where you go for work, it's going to be challenging. It's going to be difficult. You really have to try to keep yourself in the most positive, most uplifting spirit possible. So what I do, you know, thank God my job, thanks to my job, they let us listen to Spotify on our computers. So I'll put on like K-Love music or country music or, you know, chill vibes station. Music that'll like really get me in an okay mood and not make me feel like I just want to jump out the window. Because you do get moments and times where you feel like someone's coming at you some kind of way, or a patient or whatever the case may be. It's always something in life, not just at work. There's always something that wants to take your smile away, take that shine and spark away from your day. So it's really important to try to stay as positive as possible. So like, I'm gonna give you guys a perfect example today. Today, my break was at 1:30, right? So it was like maybe 12:50. And we had just finished a root canal patient. The following patient was an initial visit. So an initial visit, consists of seating the patient, you know, running through medical history, taking vitals, all that stuff. On top of that, you have to take 18 x-rays. Like, there's 32 teeth in the mouth. 18 x-rays is a lot. I literally sat the patient down. I was super happy to see the patient. I was like, hi, you know, how are you? I took it like grain of salt. I got all my x-ray rings ready to take these x-rays. I got my films ready. And I kid you not, I said, by the grace of God, with the grace of God, anything God, I was like, please, God. I opened this patient's mouth and she has a full set of dentures. So literally removed her whole top teeth and she only had like a few anterior mandibular premolars. I only had to take maybe 4 or 5 x-rays out of the 18 x-rays, which saved me so much time. We didn't even do a cleaning because it was just a clinical examination. So clinical examination, you look through the mouth, look through the teeth, make sure everything's fine, and your treatment plan, very simple. And the whole time before the patient had gotten in the room, I'm like, oh my God, it's almost 1 o'clock, I have an initial, I have to take 18 x-rays, and then we gotta do a cleaning. But I stayed positive, and that is so important in a work environment, work setting, clinical setting, especially. Just to be positive. I just feel overwhelmed with joy being able to vent through my lens and to talk to you guys on my break. It's really amazing. And like, I'm calm, I'm chill. There's always, excuse me. I always try to find joy throughout the day. Whether you're working, you're sad, you're in a tough situation, moral of the story was, I kind of wanted to put this first vlog out there. I don't know, temperature cooling or something, I don't know. But very, very quickly, I'm gonna do this outro. I'm very, very excited and happy to have been able to put this vlog out for you guys. And, you know, I just kind of want to let you guys know what I'm up to and kind of have you guys follow this journey with me, because it's something I'm very passionate about, and what you're passionate about in life, you have to go for. So this is something that I'm going for, and for those of you who are very interested in the dental field, I think you should go for it. A lot of people just think dental and they're like, oh my God, you're in someone's mouth, but it's such a reward, because a smile is everything. So I really look forward to doing more vlogs with you, especially while I'm at work. I think this is a great venting therapy session for me. So yeah, if you guys enjoyed this, give it a thumbs up. Let me know what you guys would like to see. I'm very new to this. I'm kind of just dipping my toes in the pool. So yeah, thanks guys so much for watching. It's 2:09. I'm gonna enjoy the rest of my break. Excuse me, and I'm out of here at 5. So yeah, I guess I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.